In this video, I am going to explain why changing your diet could make you feel worse before you feel better. Enjoy. Hello everybody, Dr. Brian Dizvonik here. Inside your gut, there are hundreds of species of bacteria, yeast, non-human single-celled organisms, and viruses. In a perfect world, all of your gut microbes live in harmony. They help you to digest your food, make vitamins for you, and stimulate your immune system. In biology, this type of symbiotic relationship is called mutualism, where both parties benefit. The microbes get nutrients from the fiber your body is unable to digest, and you get nutrients, vitamins, and protection from the microorganism. However, the world is not perfect, and other types of symbiotic relationships exist. Probably the most common is known as commensalism, where one organism benefits while the other organism isn't affected at all. Basically, there's a bunch of microorganisms living in your gut, living off of the food that you eat, but not necessarily causing you any harm. They're just there. And then there's a third type of symbiotic relationship known as parasitism. In this situation, the microbes benefit from stealing your food, eating the protective layer of your gut, and even sucking your blood. In this situation, they get all the benefit while you suffer. It's important to note that most species of microbes that live in your gut are not parasites, but they can become parasites if their population gets too big or if they populate areas where they shouldn't be. Let's say under normal circumstance, microbe X is a commensal organism. It eats the food that you eat, but doesn't cause you harm despite the endotoxin that it produces whenever members of its population die. If microbe X's population were to grow too large, it would no longer be a commensal organism. Instead, it would become a parasitic organism because A, it's stealing more of your food, B, it's causing a chronic immune reaction, and C, when members of its population die, it produces more endotoxin. So let's say for the past few months, you've gotten into the habit of eating too many carbohydrates. You're eating cookies, donuts, and washing it down with a 64-ounce Coke every day. Your body is not going to be able to absorb all that sugar, and whatever is left over will be fed to microbe X, which will cause its population to grow. So now, because you're eating all those carbohydrates, the population of microbe X is sustained. More are born every day and more die every day. At some point, the population of microbe X gets big enough to cause you problems. It's now a parasite. The portion of its population that dies on a regular basis every day produces enough endotoxin to start giving you some symptoms like headache. If you don't make any changes to your diet, you will continue to suffer through this cycle. You eat a bunch of sugar that feeds microbe X, its population grows, and in between meals, a portion of its population dies, producing enough endotoxin to give you chronic, annoying headaches. One day, you decide to make some significant changes to your diet. You decide to cut out carbs. You're gonna do the keto diet.
The keto diet.
You drastically lower your carbohydrate intake. No more cookies, no more donuts, no more Coke. Microbe X no longer has a food supply, and its population begins to die in drastic numbers, releasing a massive amount of endotoxin into your system. After about a week on the keto diet, you start to question whether or not you're doing the right thing because your headaches have gotten worse. You now have nausea, cramping, and diarrhea. This is the die-off reaction. Some people call it the keto flu, others call it the Jarisch-Herxheimer reaction, but basically when the bacteria die off, the endotoxins that they produce may be enough to give you symptoms. And for most folks, the symptoms generally last a couple days to a couple of weeks and may be helped by taking activated charcoal and drinking plenty of water. For any of you who have tried making significant changes to your diet and have experienced some of these things, know that over time, about 2 weeks, you will start to feel better. And if you're feeling just too crummy on this, then maybe you should take it a little slower. Don't jump into the keto diet, but just gradually over time start to lower your carbohydrates, and that may help to mitigate some of the symptoms. If you like the video, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button and click the bell so that you don't miss out on my future videos. I thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.